Hello everyone, my name is Iago Mota, and today I'll be discussing four different methods of adding more detail to smoke simulations in Blender. So, let's begin with the first one. The smoke high resolution setting is rather predictable, however, I believe it's necessary to emphasize its importance. As many of you may already know, this setting is responsible for enhancing the quality of the smoke and fire by adding to them small-scale turbulence without straying from the looks of the original simulation. This is very distinct from what you see just by increasing the domain divisions and can be a lifesaver when it comes to some simulations. Nonetheless, it still tends to intensely slow down the simulation process and can occasionally even result in smoke that does look very different from the original simulation. Within it, we have two main controllers, divisions and strength, which, as suggested by their names, control the resolution and the intensity of the turbulent noise. With that said, this feature works quite well with MantaFlow, with the only difference being the addition of the scale and time sliders that respectively increase the vorticity of the noise and control its speed. A second strategy of adding detail would be through the use of textures during the shading process. This is highly useful, especially if you're dealing with a simulation far too heavy for you to further increase the resolution. With that said, you can begin by adding a noise texture and use it to control, say, the density of the smoke. For this to be done, we just add a math node and use it to multiply the density of the smoke by the noise texture. This way, we end up with a more detailed smoke simulation. However, it currently looks extremely unrealistic as the texture is completely static. This can be fixed by adding an attribute node, typing in velocity, and connecting it into the vector input of the noise texture. Although this can be a massive lifesaver in many cases, I do have to make a quick disclaimer. Adding textures this way is not realistic, as the noise doesn't follow the smoke, but instead distorts itself according to its direction and velocity, so getting optimal results requires you to tweak many settings. Furthermore, this isn't possible with MantaFlow, since both heat and velocity aren't features that have been implemented in this new simulating framework, but hopefully this will change soon. In third place, we have particle simulations. This can be an excellent method of adding detail, especially for fire. It's also very customizable, as you can modify the physics of the simulation, change and animate different properties of the particles, and modify the material at any time. But with all that exposition out of the way, here is one of the ways it can be achieved. Firstly, make sure that the smoke simulation is baked at a low resolution so that the particle animation plays at a decent speed. This will make the workflow much easier. In order to begin the whole process, we need an object to emit the particles. For that, you can either add a new object or just use the smoke emitter. After giving it a particle system, reduce both normal velocity and gravity to zero so that there won't be any unwanted movement among the particles. And finally, add a smoke flow force field in the same layer as the particle emitter. Select the domain object over here and make sure to save the file because Blender has a tendency of crashing when you simulate using this force field for the first time in a scene. Nevertheless, it works perfectly fine when you reopen the file and resume the simulation. Now it's just a matter of messing around with the smoke flow parameters until you get something interesting. Afterward, hide the particle simulation in the settings, bake the final high-res smoke simulation, and then bake the particles. Of course, you can also add a particle object and shade it however you like. There's much more you can do using this method, here I just talked about the very basics of it, and thankfully this also works in MantaFlow, however, requiring you to strongly increase the flow and decrease the strength settings in the smoke flow force field. Lastly, we have my personal favorite, using the additional feature under the adaptive domain settings. When making large-scale smoke simulations, if there is anything that can be called a magic bullet, this feature is it. More precisely, increasing it adds additional cells to the domain, making it bigger. To compensate for this change in size, you can just scale it down and end up with a simulation that isn't just more detailed, but also larger in scale. Please note, however, that this isn't a good way to get around adding force fields and tweaking the behavior of the simulation to make it look bigger. I suggest only using this when the basic behavior of the smoke simulation looks decent. With that said, this is a great final touch to add to your simulations, but unfortunately, it's not available in MantaFlow just yet. And those were my four favorite ways of adding detail to smoke and fire in Blender. If you have any other suggestions, it would be great to read about them in the comment section below. Also, consider visiting my Patreon page. Even if you don't have the time to support me, I suggest taking a look at it since it's a great platform for me to post updates and interact with everyone, which is quite a nice addition considering my uploads on YouTube are quite scarce. Anyway, thank you for watching.